Dream Media brings the word of God to you from the mouth of God's servant, Reverend S.O. Academy, the preacher of righteousness. God bless you as you sit back to listen.
I'm going to talk about the fact that the blessing is in the bloodline. The blessing. I'll just do a preaching, not teaching now. Everybody say the blessing in the bloodline. Say it again. The blessing in the bloodline. Say it. When we talk of bloodline, we are talking of there is a bloodline. When we say we are bloodly related, that means we have the same blood. The same blood is flowing through us. The same blood is flowing through us. The same DNA possibly flowing through us. There is the blessing that is in the bloodline. Just as you have curses in the bloodline. So you also have blessing in the bloodline. We have spoken so much about carriers of the blessing. That the blessing is inherited, you don't struggle to get it. It started with the Abrahamic covenant, and it continues when Jesus Christ died on the cross. He engraved us into that Abrahamic covenant. We are carriers of these blessings of God. In Psalm 112, verse 1 to 2, the Bible says, Psalm 112, verse 1 and 2, it said, "Praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in his commandments. His seed shall be mighty upon earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed." Praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord and that delighteth greatly in his commandment. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth. Your seed shall be mighty on this earth. Because you have not yet given birth or you are not yet married, that is not enough not to say a big amen. I say your seed shall be mighty on the surface of the earth. It is not good that your children should be less than you. Are you hearing me? Your children should be greater than you. That is why you must do everything to give them the foundation that will make them greater than you. Prepare them for that. Remember, of this church told me how the father said, "Oh, so you want to be like me, eh? None of you, my children, can be like me." I say, I rebuke that thing out of his mouth. You not only you not just be like him, you be greater, much, much greater than him in the name of Jesus Christ. And today, they are already getting greater than him. Say amen. That is a blessing in the bloodline. Say, your seed shall be mighty upon earth, not in heaven. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. I say your generation shall be blessed. Look, we don't just take prayer of the present. I like doing things that have everlasting value or eternal value or a long-lasting value. We pronounce blessing on you now that we want to see. Each time I'm preaching, I see you beyond just today. I see you beyond the pandemic period. I see you beyond 2020. I see you from the day you are born to the day you will leave this world or to the day Jesus will come. That is the style I use in praying. Please take note of that. So when I say your generation shall be blessed, please take note of that. I say the generation of the upright. You are the upright. Once you are born again, you are the upright. You are the righteousness of God. Your generation shall be blessed in the name of Jesus. Know that what your generation will carry the blessing. That's what that scripture is saying. Your generation will carry the blessing of God. Praise God. From what we read, few things come to mind. Number one, the fear of the Lord delivers the blessing. Everybody say the fear of the Lord. Let me give you a few points. Anywhere I reach, we stop. Number one, the fear of the Lord delivers the blessing. Everybody say the fear of the Lord. You can read it here. He said in the scripture we read, "Blessed is the man that fear the Lord." The man that fears the Lord gets blessed. The word blessed here means empowered to prosper is the man that fears God. Empowered to prosper is the man that fears God. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. What does it mean to fear God? Proverbs 8 verse 13 made us to know that the fear makes you to hate evil. When you fear God, you hate evil. From the word of God that you load in your spirit, you speak against evil in your soul and in your body. You subject your body to the word of God. You subject your soul to the word of God. You hate evil. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. Proverbs 8 and verse 13. Obedience displays your fears of God. When you have obedience, obedience knocks out fear. When you obey God, fear will leave your life. In Genesis chapter 22, can somebody open to that place? Genesis 22, verse 12 to 14. And he said, lay not thy hand upon the land, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God. See, that is obedience. See, thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son from me. God was speaking to Abraham when he told him to bring his son and sacrifice his son unto him. And Abraham obeyed sheepishly. The Bible now says, and he said, lay not thy hand, I'm still in verse 12, lay not thy hand upon the land, neither do thou anything unto him, for now I know that thou fearest God. When you fear God, you obey God. I mean, this is the greatest, terrible thing God can ever ask you to do. Kill your son. Then I know you fear God. And he was ready to do that. Hallelujah. May the fear of God dominate our heart in Jesus' name. I say, may the fear of God dominate your heart in Jesus' name. Secondly, your belief without wavering is your relief. From Abraham truly believe God. Your belief without wavering is your relief. If you truly believe God, you don't waver, you don't doubt anything, you will be relieved. That's why Jesus made that remark. See, the work of God is to believe on him whom God has sent, to believe in Jesus. God made that remark. If you believe in Jesus, if he said, kill your son, you are ready to kill your son. That means you believe. So people have done some very wild things because they believe God. So that is so important. Your belief without wavering. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. Oh, raise up your right hand and say, Father, help my unbelief. You know, why am I praying that prayer in the Bible? Say, help my own. Any area I'm disbelieving you, help me. God can just be speaking to you. Just pay your tithe. Say, under this pandemic, God, wait. When pandemic is over, I will join all together and pay. And he said, you are not serious. You have unbelief in your heart. Praise God. The last one, maybe. I have so many to talk about, but I always believe you can't pray the Bible in one day. Anywhere you reach, you stop. Your children must be trained about the blessing. Are you hearing me? Please, what I'm about to explain, don't say you have no children yet. You will have children. Learn it now. Your children must be trained about the blessing. I told you, I preach to you, looking at you from now to the end of age. To the end of age. Abraham trained his children about the blessing. That was so important. When he had Isaac, he must have explained to Isaac all that happened to him, the story of his life. He must have explained how the blessing came upon him. Can we read Genesis 18 verse 19? It's so important. Genesis 18 verse 19. For I know him that he will command his children and his household after him. And they shall keep the will of the Lord to do justice and judgment. That the Lord, do what? That the Lord may bring upon Abraham that which he has spoken of him. For I know him. Listen to me. This is so powerful. I believe God said, I know Abraham. May God know us in Jesus' name. He said, I know him that he will command his children. What do you do to your children? What do you do to them? He said he will command his children. Please leave that in there. He will command his children after him. This is the greatest challenge we have in the body of Christ today. For I know him. I know him. For your children to be great. Please remember our major text, Psalm 112, verse 1 and 2 that we read. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Your children shall be greater than you. But for that to happen, he said something in Genesis 18, verse 19. For I know Abraham, who was a carrier of the blessing. He wouldn't want to die with the blessing. He wouldn't want his generation next yet unborn to be better than, to be less than him. How will he make them not to be less than him? He said, I know him, that he will command his children and his household after him. He didn't say after God, though. After what? The difference between he will command the children after God. But he said he will command the children after who? After himself. I know him. God wants to say the same thing about you. I know you. That you will bring up your children after yourself. The whole of your household. After yourself. That means you must be exemplary. Is that not so? You must be what? Exemplary. You must be what you want them to be. For them to be after you. You will command your children. Everybody say command. Not suggest to your children. Not, just tell if they like it or not. No, you will command your children after yourself. God should know you to that level of commanding your children after you. You take time. Abraham must have explained to the children. This was the way I was born. Before I was born, there was a curse in the family. At the age of 29 to 35 years, somebody will be born. But my father got to 70 years before he gave back to me. And even when I was born, I couldn't give back to you. I was over 100 years before I gave back to you. He must have explained to him all the fight he fought. How Lot was kidnapped. How he went to fight with 318 people. How he paid tithe to Melchizedek. That he paid tithe, my son, me, your father, I paid tithe to Melchizedek. A type of Christ. So, you will be paying tithe. This was the life I live. I love my brother. When my brother was struggling with me, I say, if you go right, I go left. If you go left, I go right. I don't need to struggle. And he went the way he went. And the way, the one he left for me, he was even the one that delivered him when they kidnapped him. I know Abraham. He will teach his children, Isaac, he will explain all that he went through. How he never got anything free of charge. Even when they dash, he said, I will pay for it. So that tomorrow you not say you are the one that make me rich. I know Abraham. He will bring up his children in the ways of the Lord. He will command them. Hey, brethren, when I read this earlier on, earlier in life and ministry, I saw that your Christianity is tested more on your children. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Your Christianity is tested more on the outcome of your children. And I look at scripture. A man like Samuel. A honorable man of God. All that he said comes surely to pass. 1 Samuel 9 verse 6. Yet he could not bring up his children well. A man like his children were rioters. One of them was called Abia. I don't know. He's not from Abia State in Nigeria. Praise God. They live a terrible life. What of Eli? His children. They were doing terrible things inside church. They said, this is the way sacrifice. They said, no, forget about that thing. I will collect, I will break all the law of God. And when that dawned on us, when we started preaching, raising children, we began to pray to God to have mercy on us. All men and women of God, everybody here, God wants to say, I know you, that you raise your children after you. You first and foremost, you have to be exemplary. You have to live a life you want them to live. He will command the children. Not he will suggest, he command them. May your children not go off hands. In the name of Jesus Christ. Where you say, sit here, they say no. Let's go to church, say no. Let's wake up in the morning and pray together, say no. Daddy, I don't, I'm not praying. Mommy, you have your own prayer to pray. You better pray your prayer. Here, in my house. God forbid. Are you hearing me? That's why you should give back to the number of children you can bring up after you and after God. Are you hearing me? I know him. He will command the children. It's very painful. I've seen all kinds of things. We are raising up our children, six of them. I knew what it took us. She's here. In prayers, in fasting, every day, we must pray together. We must read Bible together. They must preach the Bible. None of my children preach the Bible less than 20 years in my house. Are you hearing me? Every morning, they must preach. I have two of them here. They know what I'm talking about. They must preach the word of God every day. We preach together. We preach according to ages. Start from the lowest. Or, I think from mommy now. Then after that, all the children, according to their age. Then me, I will now be the pastor of the house. And now random. They be each of them be to 20 years Bible school inside my house. Are you hear what I'm saying? All Aaron's children, we are priests like him. Hope you know that. He brought them up to become Aaronic children, to become priests. The Bible says we are kings and priests in Revelation 1 verse 6, in Revelation 5 verse 10. We are kings and priests, we shall reign on earth. Bring up your children in the ways of the Lord. I never allowed my daughters, as long as they were with me, none of them wore trousers, one day I'd be roaming about, open stomach down, and dressed like prostitutes. I mean, no, it never happened once. None of them used phone until they entered university. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You are not allowed. None of them sat at home while I'm in church. It has never happened once. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That I'm sitting in church, my son is at home, doing what? My daughter is sitting there, doing what? It's good to even daughters first. God, you train them. The other boys will just come and become like their children too. We read Bible together, study Bible together. We keep praying. Lord, help us. Help us. Let them not go and be wayward. They, you know, pastor children face the same thing every other person faces. Some people think that they are special people. No. They are tempted like any other person. In fact, devil tempts them the more. Devil wants to make sure they do something terrible. A man of God in Ghana, his son now is speaking nonsense on the internet. Say, you call yourself a man of God. You lock me up. Now no devil at work. How can you lock your son? Great man of God. I beg all of you here, don't do everything. If you fail in home, you have failed in life. If you fail, Idama told us, anybody that fails in your family life, that is, you have failed totally in life. Apart from your spiritual life, the most important next thing is your family life. Don't fail in that area. Three children, I know him, for I know him. Put it there so that they will know. I know him, bring up children after himself. Then you want to be exemplary. I know a father, a husband and wife, when they want to quarrel, their little kids of 4 or 5 years, they lock them inside the room and lock them. Say, yes, when you talk. After they finish quarrel, they open the door. Children come out. So you don't hear our quarrel. But some parents, in the presence of their children, hey, I deal with you. The child will say, Daddy, it's okay now. Daddy, you don't beat mommy now. Daddy, don't beat mommy. Mommy, you're talking. How will you slap daddy first? Praise God. And that becomes it. By the time those children grow up, Tell me what kind of person they want to become. There are some people refuse to marry because of the way their father treated their mother. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There are some ladies. They are afraid. Even they are afraid to marry. See, if marriage is what I saw between my father and mother, then marriage is not worth it. I know him. Oh, may God help us. It's not something you struggle for. You need to, like I keep saying, depend on him. Is that clear? Depend on the Holy Spirit. Let him help you to raise these children. And be prayerful. Be prayerful. There's no pride in it. It's just God doing it. And be talking to your children. Are you blessed today?
Thank you for listening. We are sure you've really been blessed by this. For inquiries, please call 080-370-30885. God bless you.